James Harden, without a doubt, one of the best shooting guards in the NBA currently. Without a doubt, one of the best shooting guards of all time. I just said it. Those are my words. I'm going to stand by it. I really do think James Harden is one of the best scorers to ever play the game of basketball. I think he's such a good scorer that his passing gets overlooked. And I think that's a really unfortunate situation. Imagine being too good at something that it undermines the rest of your skill set. Just like Chris Paul, when it's all said and done, I think James Harden will be one of the most underappreciated players of our generation. You want to talk about guys that changed the game of basketball? James Harden, without a doubt, is one of them. That same hate they gave AI, that same love they didn't want to give Allen Iverson, they're now giving to James Harden. And they do the same with Russell Westbrook. About a week or two ago, I kind of made a video on Russell Westbrook's entire career and how doubted he's been throughout his career. Russ will be the first to tell you he was never supposed to make the NBA. But I'm not going to sit here and spoil the video. If you want to watch it, it's on my channel. It's called Russell Westbrook's Story Will Change Your Opinion of Him Forever. I'm going to start doing more videos like that. So in the comments below, let me know what players' stories you want to hear. Because on this channel, we're looking to please everybody. James Harden and Russell Westbrook, man, it sucks. Such high expectations that just haven't been met. And time again, we just see people doubt these players. We see people doubt James Harden. We see people doubt Russell Westbrook. Can this duo work? Was the small ball idea a good idea? If you say no, then what now? You look at a Rockets team that doesn't have a legit traditional big on the roster. I know they got guys, but at this stage of their career, these guys aren't good. While I love what the Rockets have done, I love what they tried to do with Russell Westbrook, I thought the all-in on small ball was a little ignorant and stubborn. I'll tell you, I loved it. I made one of my best videos hyping up the Houston Rockets because I was bought in. But there was one thing I could never figure out. Why not go out and try to find a traditional big just in case you run into a situation where small ball isn't working? The Warriors were very well known for small ball, but that doesn't mean on game day they're not going to have a 7-footer at least active on the roster. And while I'm sort of speaking in hyperbole, you guys understand where I am coming from. Now, I've made videos time and time again this offseason already on the Rockets' future. We've talked about there being a lot of doubt. Now the doubt isn't just coming from me, it's coming from some of the Rockets players. Things aren't looking good, and there's no way to tell if they will get better. Be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications because you will not want to miss another Get Like Coop video, and that's facts. NBA 2K21 Next Gen is here. We're going to be streaming that 5 times a week. The link to my stream is going to be in the description below. Be sure to stop by. I'm telling you, it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm very interactive with the chat, just like I am on my channel. I try to answer as many comments as possible. I see your support on the channel. I see the positivity, and trust me, guys, I appreciate it so much. Okay, so I'm not sure how reliable Kendrick Perkins is when it comes to news and breaking news, but I'm sure he's somebody that at the very least is tapped in. So we're going to go ahead and roll this Kendrick Perkins clip, and then we're going to discuss it. Now, before I play the clip, I just want to preface the clip by saying there's a lot more information coming than just this clip. Go ahead and roll it.
James have not been answering the phone for the ownership or the front office or even Coach Silas for about 2 weeks now. It's because they don't feel included in the process.
So a quick cliff note, this has actually been disputed by Tim, by Woj. He says no trade requests have been made, and Harden remains engaged with front office personnel decisions. Just let's assume what Kendrick Perkins is saying has some weight and it's true. Let's give Big Perk the benefit of the doubt. James Harden and Russell Westbrook not answering the phone is about as bad as things get, you would think, but they actually get much, much worse. I'm not sure how a team like the Houston Rockets can go about making personnel decisions without having James Harden and Russell Westbrook tapped in. If these reports are true, it just does not make any sense, especially when you've put so much into building around these two players already. You don't have draft capital. You don't have a lot of assets to work with. At the very least, you want to make sure these two guys are happy. You announced this offseason you don't want to trade them. We'll start putting the work in to make sure you don't end up having to trade them. I don't know about you guys, but at the end of the day, I learned at a very young age that actions will always mean much more than words. I think that's applicable to this situation. So you hear Kendrick Perkins say this and that about the Houston Rockets, and oh, maybe Perkins is a Rockets hater. Here's the thing. There was a report that came out earlier this morning that James Harden and Russell Westbrook have expressed concerns about the Rockets' immediate future. So this is coming from Woj. This isn't just coming from anybody. These aren't just any sources. So when James Harden and Russell Westbrook are frustrated and already looking ahead to the future, it's safe to assume that they're already wondering, is H-Town going to be a long-term fit for us? Now, it's no secret James Harden has made it known he wants to retire in Houston. To me, this has kind of been James Harden's city. Before Harden arrived, my pops was a season ticket holder for the Houston Rockets. We used to go to a good bit of games. I was really, really young. But I remember how weak those crowds were. Harden's arrival in Houston kind of reset the city. It gave Houston a jolt that it sorely needed. I'm sure James Harden and Russell Westbrook are incredibly frustrated after going out how they did in the second round of the NBA playoffs, especially after barely escaping the first round. You can make an argument that that series was the Thunder's to lose, and they lost it. I think Harden and Russ still have a lot of potential that hasn't necessarily been met, but there is a lot of questions surrounding the fit of Harden and Russell Westbrook. When Russell Westbrook was playing his best basketball, he was looking like an MVP this season. Though for whatever reason, it never felt like Harden and Westbrook would go off in a collaborative effort. I know it happened, and you could say it happened somewhat frequently, but it never truly felt like their games were complementing each other's. A lot of their great games came from these two staggering their minutes. In the Rockets offense, unfortunately, for either of these two to be their most effective, they needed the basketball in their hands. If Westbrook had the ball, a lot of times Harden's just standing around. If Harden had the ball, Westbrook would try to space and occasionally move without the ball, but if he's not able to knock down a jump shot, then his offensive impact goes way down. We saw the Lakers guard Russell Westbrook with Anthony Davis, giving him free range to do whatever he wanted on the defensive side of the basketball. And of course, that wouldn't be the first time this season that we saw bigs match up against Russell Westbrook. There's one thing I've noticed so far, and that's where there's water, there's typically a leak. You have to find it. So much news came out on the Houston Rockets today, it's hard to imagine that this is all fake. This is all some type of fabricated nonsense. But of course, like I always say, rumors can be good. Not saying these are rumors though, because we even saw Woj report some of this stuff. But rumors can be good because they often lead us to the truth. The truth will eventually come out. Now, Clutch NBA reported that James Harden has quietly communicated with people close to him that if the Rockets decide to blow it up, he already has a few teams in mind. The Miami Heat, the Brooklyn Nets, and the Philadelphia 76ers. Now, when you think of the Miami Heat, some people are going to think of James Harden for Jimmy Butler swap. Jimmy's from Houston. Harden in Miami could be absolutely ferocious. Not me. I look at the Miami Heat more so trading Hero, trading a lot of first round picks, trading a lot of capital and assets to go after James Harden. I'm not a fan of a lot of these other Miami Heat moves, the Miami Heat going after Oladipo, Drew Holiday. You get James Harden, you might go ahead and win that championship. You get Drew, you got a shot, but I don't think it's the best shot in the world. And I know the Miami Heat are just coming from the finals, but James Harden, Bam Adebayo, Jimmy Butler, you can't really put Harden in a better situation than in Miami. And I'm talking about from a basketball fit, not being the best team possible. James Harden, when he locks in, a fantastic defender, very versatile, elite for a guard down on the block. Harden to Brooklyn sounds fun, but man, there's only so much basketball to go around. I would love the reunion of Harden with D'Antoni, but man, we kind of already saw how that ends. But of course, Harden didn't have Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving by his side. Naturally, the Brooklyn Nets have a lot of assets. This team has the tools to make maybe a somewhat interesting offer. I'm not sure, because I'm sure what the Rockets will be looking to get back for it. And Harden is a franchise cornerstone type of talent. Now, Jared Allen has a lot of potential, as does LeVert. But do you think these guys are going to be franchise cornerstones? I don't know. I'm very high on Allen. I think he has the potential to be. He's just a little bit of an unknown right now. And then when it comes to Philadelphia, I'm not really sure what trade makes sense there that doesn't involve Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid. Now, if you guys think the 76ers should part with one of those guys for James Harden, let me know down in the comments below. Let's go ahead and discuss this. And look, don't get it confused. I'm not saying Hero and a bunch of assets is enough for Harden, because if I'm the Rockets, I'm going after Bam Adebayo. Not saying that's what the trade would end up being if it were to happen, but if I'm the Rockets, I want Bam. I want Harden to get a ring bad, really bad. You guys know how much I've supported him throughout his career. Let's try to put together some trades in the comments below for James Harden, for Russell Westbrook. And now with everything I have just said, Russell Westbrook is now demanding a trade out of Houston. This is coming right from Shams. You cannot make this up. I want to know down in the comments below what you think the best destinations for Russell Westbrook are. I honestly, when I started making this video, I had no idea it was going to unravel this fast. Remember what I told you guys, where there's water, there's likely a leak. The Rockets being scared of the future had to be no secret, more so James Harden and Russell Westbrook. I'm talking about Russell Westbrook can flat out go. I hope he goes to a team that truly does understand how to utilize him and understands the type of special talent that he is. Russell Westbrook can be a key piece to a contending team. He just has to find the right fit. Before Russell Westbrook came to Houston, he had seasons where he would shoot 35%+ on catch and shoot threes. You just have to find a way to use him. Keep in mind, when he finished the season with the Rockets, he was coming back from an injury, and you can argue he came back too soon. This is huge news. The NBA offseason is just getting started. Subscribe. You're not going to want to miss an update. Clicking the video on the screen right now is a great way to support the channel. I'm Get Like Coop, giving you guys the scoop. Until the next video.